Have you wondered how you can actually validate an online course idea? Like, how can you actually know that it's going to be worth your time creating that course? Because no one wants to spend months and months creating an online course or a new program that is ultimately going to flop. So, in this episode, I'm diving into how you can validate your course idea in the marketplace. This episode was actually from a short talk I did at the recent GEM conference. We got incredible feedback from the audience about this session. So I knew I wanted to share it here with you. All right, let's roll the tape. You're listening to the Passive Project Podcast, where we talk about how to build your online business to make more income, more impact, and give you more freedom in your life. I'm Gemma Bonham-Carter, business strategist, mom of two, lover of passive income, automation, and coffee. Welcome to the podcast. Hey guys, it's Gemma here again from GemmaBonhamCarter.com. So we have gone through, I gave a presentation on email marketing. This presentation is all about online courses because maybe you own a brick and mortar business and you are pivoting in this current season. Maybe you are a service-based entrepreneur who does one-to-one work and you're ready to leverage the one-to-many model. Maybe you're a creative entrepreneur and you're just ready to monetize in a new way. Whatever the reason is that you're interested in online courses, I'm here to tell you online courses are the bomb. I have like monetized and grown my own business since 2016, largely through digital products, through online courses, memberships, and other kind of digital downloads. And there, it's a big wide world out there of things that you can like learn with online courses, and it can feel overwhelming and big and maybe a little bit scary. But it doesn't have to be that way. And it can be a lot more simple and streamlined if you just let it be that way. So what I wanted to talk to you guys about today in this presentation is not so much the how-to of like how to build out a course or the tech tools that you might look at for building a course. I want to talk to you about pre-selling a course, because this is probably the number one thing that I wish that I had understood when I launched my first course. So let me rewind a little minute and just tell you that story. So I launched my first course at the end of 2016. I had been giving a lot of presentations at conferences about blogging and about monetizing your blog, because I was a home decor and lifestyle blogger, and I had made, I turned it into a pretty legit side hustle. And so I was getting these invites to come and speak at blogging conferences. And I was getting a lot of questions from the audience about this topic. So I thought, okay, I'm going to create a course about this. I'm going to sell it. It's going to be great. I'm going to make a bunch of money. Look at all these people making six figures selling online courses. I want to be one of them. So let me do this thing. And here's where I went wrong. I spent months creating the course. I created incredible video lessons and downloadables and mapped it all out and spent tons of time creating this entire program. And I had actually purchased a course on how to make courses for like over $1,000. And I followed all the steps that that course laid out for me. But what it didn't tell me to do was to validate my course idea before going and creating it. And it's what I wish I had have known, because my course ended up being a flop. I made a handful of sales. It didn't take off the way I had hoped it would. And there were some mistakes about my actual offer. Like, it wasn't niched enough. I didn't have a big enough transformation. My ideal client wasn't clear enough. And some other things related to the offer. And I would have known that if I had tried to pre-sell it and actually get founding students in through the door before I went and created it. So that is what I want your biggest takeaway from today to be, is that if you want to launch an online course, the best thing you can do is think through the offer, think through what your course would look like, what would it include, what is it that you're teaching people? Because ultimately, any successful online course solves a problem, right? It solves a problem that people are experiencing in your market. and you're going to provide results for them through your course. And so map out what the offer looks like, but then you actually have to validate that offer before you go and create it. And the way you validate is by pre-selling. And the whole gist behind pre-selling is that you have founding students who purchase the program from you before you have created it. So you can give them a really clear idea of what's going to be included. You'll have the, you know, you might have the modules ready to go. You know exactly what you're going to deliver. Let's say it's like a 6-week course on, I don't know, how to use Instagram as a food blogger. And you may have it all mapped out of what the modules are going to be and what all is going to be included. And you have all of that, but you haven't actually created it yet. And what you do first is go and reach out to food bloggers and make sure that you have, you know, a solid 10 or 15 food bloggers who are actually going to buy in to the program before you've created it. And usually what you do is offer the founding students like the best deal ever. It's like probably something in the range of 25 to 50% less than the eventual price you want to end up at. So let's say your course is going to be a $9.97 course. Maybe you pre-sell it for something like $6.97 or $7.99, something like that. So they're getting like the best deal that will ever exist in your program. And they're also getting probably more one-on-one support from you inside of the program, because what you want to do with those founding students is you want to offer them incredible support so that they get results. Because if they get results from your program, it means you get testimonials. And the more testimonials you get, the easier it is to keep selling your program over time, because social proof and case studies are what can be It just can make your marketing of your course so much easier. So that's what we're after with those founding students. So the three techniques that you can use to pre-sell your course. Number one is a validation webinar. So host a live webinar, a live masterclass, get people to sign up for it. And on that webinar, you are going to tell your story. You're going to do some teaching around your topic. And ultimately, at the end, you're going to present your offer, which is your course. And you want to have, you know, urgency there for people to purchase the course. So let's say you have an open cart period for something like 5 days or 10 days, something like that. And you're giving them this founding student rate. So that would be technique number one to pre-sell your course, is through a free live webinar. Option number two to pre-sell your course is to do actually a paid webinar. And it's a little different. It's not like your typical webinar. It's more like a paid workshop. So let's say, let's go with the example of, let's say you're wanting to create a course on how to use Instagram for food bloggers. Well, for this paid workshop, can you pull out one specific topic within that you could teach a workshop on? So it might be something related to using Instagram stories, let's say. And so you could offer a paid workshop. Let's say it's in the range of $47 to $97, somewhere in there, where you do a paid live workshop on this particular topic. And so this is doing two things. Number one is it's validating just that there's interest in your idea, that there people are going to pay just to learn more about your topic. But then the second thing you can do is then upsell those people to the course. So anybody who purchased the live workshop can then be upsold into your bigger program. You can say, okay, well, if you found this really interesting, here's a way to keep learning more from me about this. And again, they would get that founding member rate. And usually what you would do is, let's say they paid $97 for that mini workshop, you would apply the $97 to their enrollment fee in your program. So that's option number two. Option number one, a free webinar. Option number two is a paid live workshop. Usually those are around 2 hours long, maybe like an hour and a half of content and half an hour for Q&A. And then the third way that you can pre-sell your program is to actually just have one-on-one conversations, right? This might look like sales calls. It might look like one-on-one convos, like in your DMs, over Instagram, over Facebook Messenger, anywhere where you can just like get visible and talk about the program that you're putting together. Might even be in an email to your email list. And then invite people to have a conversation with you. So whether that means messaging you in the DMs or just commenting on your post and then you follow up in the DMs or a back and forth on email, or actually hopping on like Zoom or Google Meet or some sort of live video chat so that you can then talk to them about what the program is going to include, figure out whether they're the right fit, and then make them the offer of becoming a founding student. That's how you can create a pre-sale situation for your course using one-on-one combos. And true story, I purchased a $12,000 program through a one-on-one convo with somebody who I had been following for a long time. I liked her. I trusted her. I knew that she was just a few steps ahead of me, and I wanted to learn what she had done to get there. And her program was just coming out the gate with this new program. She didn't have a perfect sales page. She didn't have testimonials and case studies, but she was talking about this program that she was going to create. And it sounded like something that was right up my alley. And I think she posted something like the perfect ideal student for the program and sort of comment below if that's you. And I commented below. She followed up in the DMs. We had a one-on-one back and forth conversation. She explained what it was all going to be about, asked me some questions. I was super on board. She sent me the link to a checkout page for $12,000. Still to this day, it's the most I've paid for a program. And it was the best decision I'd ever made for my business. And so I didn't need the fancy launch and the fancy sales page. I just needed that one-on-one convo to be able to know that it was the right fit for me and to trust her and then to buy. So the idea here, whether you use the free webinar, the paid live workshop, or the one-on-one conversations, bottom line is the idea is you want to have founding students, a group of them, through the door before you even create your course content, so that number one, you have validated the idea. You know that people are willing to pull out their hard-earned dollars and pay you money for this course, because giving it away for free to beta testers is not a validation technique. And then number two is that you're actually getting paid to create the course, because I don't want you going and spending weeks or months of your time creating all of this content in a program that you don't even know sells. And so when you get founding students through the door, I mean, let's say your program, let's say you're selling it for $300 or $500 and you get 10, 15, 20 founding students through the door, you've just made yourself a nice little payday that's going to help pay for any software that you need to use to create your course, for just your time in creating your course, right? And you've just gotten the ball rolling on this entire new course empire that you are going to build for yourself. So that is my biggest tip for new course creators, is pre-selling and validating your course concept before actually creating all of your content. Now, if you want to know more about all of this, I am actually doing a webinar, a masterclass, on June 7th, it's going to be a live masterclass. We're going to go into so much more detail on how to create and launch your first online course, and a course that is going to be profitable and sell and start really building this new avenue for your business. So if you want to join me on that, head on over to gemmabonhamcarter.com/masterclass so you can get all of the details and snag your spot. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I am excited to dive into the Q&A with you. Ready to launch your own online course? Snag a seat in my free on-demand masterclass, How to Launch an Irresistible Online Course That Sells, even if you haven't nailed your niche, don't have a big audience, or think your market is saturated. In this class, I'm showing you how to validate your idea and get students before you've even created the course, the three factors that result in a course fail, and how to successfully launch a course without a giant audience. Plus, I'll be sharing the story of how I made $13,000 with my course before I even had an Instagram account. Snag a seat at gemmabonhamcarter.com/masterclass and get ready to change your business and your life.